Hi, everyone. I wanted to reach out to touch base with you now that we are coming back to school after, I think for all of us, what has been one of the most incredible, exciting, frustrating, motivating, discouraging, encouraging, wonderful, challenging times of our careers. I know it has been for me, and talking with so many of you has been for you as well. Here's what I want to make sure that you know above anything else. You have done something remarkable, something that even in my wildest dreams, I didn't know was possible. And that was to show everyone in the country and even the world that Oklahoma supports public education. You led and the people of Oklahoma followed, and we will never be the same because of your leadership. Now it means that what happens next is critical to making that truly the case. But you've led, and I'm confident that your leadership will continue, and I know for sure that the Tulsa Board of Education and I will continue supporting you, and we'll keep working on all of that together. Wanted to touch on a few things in this video and try to keep it short. One is that I tweeted something out and put it on Facebook earlier about scapegoating, and it was a little bit cryptic, and I wanted to explain a little bit more where I was coming from on that. I think what I'm seeing happen is that as we're getting back and we're sort of all, you know, dealing with the emotions and the having the chance to reflect on what happened and where we are, I'm seeing some finger pointing, and most of it with merit. You know, this was all completely uncharted territory for all of us, and so I can look back on my own decisions, for example, and think about, well, gosh, I wish I'd done this, or wish I'd said that at this moment, or talked to this person, or made this announcement, or how could we have handled it better or differently? And I am quite confident that the same is true for so many people, all of us maybe. When you think about the big players in this situation, one of the groups that is getting a lot of heat is the Oklahoma Education Association, and by association, our Tulsa Classroom Teachers Association, about the walkout ending and what was accomplished and whatnot. And here's what's really important to know. The Oklahoma Education Association had been working on these advocacy efforts for a year. This isn't something that just happened overnight because of some social media efforts or things like that. It does not mean that the efforts that happened, some of the grassroots advocacy that happened, wasn't important. It's just that those two things can be true at the same time. And I would also say that when you think about, you know, what did or didn't happen with OEA's leadership, you know, we could easily, and I have, made comments about, well, you know, if this had gone the way that many people had hoped it would, we would have waited to have the walkout later so that there was a specific bill that we were all getting behind, so that we knew what success looked like and when you know, the effort would be over, because we would all know whether it was accomplished or not. But here's the thing, you know, that grassroots effort that meant that the date was April 1st instead of later in April or in May, that was organic, and OEA followed membership's efforts when the advocacy happened for the date to be sooner. And so because of that, there was some you know, lack of clarity about what success would look like, because when you put out a plan, you know that you're not going to get everything in your plan. It's different from a specific bill that's been introduced in a lot of ways. So I say all that just to say that all of us could sit here and I can say, I should have done this differently. We could have said, you know, OEA should have been more consistent. We could have said the grassroots folks, you know, are all over the place and aren't following the lead of organized efforts and organizations. There's a little bit of truth in all of that. But it doesn't really matter Because while we all should be thinking about what we could have done differently, how we can do better in the future, that's what we do as learners and lifelong learners and educators. What really matters is what we do from this point forward. And what won't help is to sit around and point fingers at each other or to tear each other down, tear down other efforts or that kind of thing. So just strongly encourage everyone to rally behind our teams. Make change within your organizations if that's what you choose to do, but let's not tear each other apart in public, because what matters most is that all of us who are pro public education, from any organization we're from or no organization or any political party or no political party, are staying focused and tight and unified about our advocacy for our children. So there's that. On the days of instruction, we announced today that Tulsa Public Schools would be going through May 31st for students, and then we will have two teacher days after that, June 1st and June 4th. I'm not going to, in this video, go over the specifics of all the days. We'll put something out so that you can see it in writing, but know that we have checked and triple checked these days and hours and minutes. For our students, they will be getting fewer minutes than we would have if we had kept on a regular schedule, but they will still be well above the state minimum number of minutes that students are supposed to have. And then for our teachers, we'll be completing the full amount of the contract, which we're required to do by state law. So it's all been reviewed, and we've worked with the Tulsa Classroom Teachers Association on that. I know that some people wanted us to get out earlier and add minutes as opposed to not adding minutes and getting out later. And I will say that we try to listen to folks. This is one of those examples of where no matter which decision you make, there are pros and cons to doing it. And groups of people will be unhappy with the decision whichever way it goes. I do feel confident that what we've done is the right decision. If we had tried to get out on the 23rd, we would have had to have added more than an hour in school, and that would have meant that our middle school students would be in school after 5. And, you know, with everything with buses and childcare and after school activities and sports and just everything that goes into that, plus how school adding minutes is less meaningful than full days of instruction, I really do feel like it was the right decision. But if you have any questions about that, let us know. And then lastly, I just want to say that I've been so grateful to see so many of our members of our team thanking our partners who have been incredible to us during all of this, feeding and taking care of our children and keeping them safe and engaged. All of Oklahoma stepped up, but Tulsa stepped up in a beautiful, amazing, awesome way. And I want to make sure that we all continue to thank them for that. So with that, I want to end by saying thank you again. You are truly an inspiration to me. I am grateful and honored to be your superintendent, and I'm so excited about our next steps together, and I know that great things are going to come from it as you continue to lead and the rest of us continue to support you. Thank you.